Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Hey guys, here are newsmaking headlines for Filipinos in North America. This wildfire in the northeast part of Texas has become the largest blaze in the state's history, burning more than a million acres of land, displacing hundreds of residents and livestock, and burning homes and farms. The Texas A&M Forest Service says it is battling dozens of active wildfires as of Thursday across the Texas Panhandle, which began Monday near Amarillo, where the Sola family lives.
Nakakatakot, lahat kami rito nasiglabasan, yung mga kapitbahay ko nasiglabasan yan, dahil ito halos sobrang foggy na, tapos sobrang sakit sa ilong, hindi mo mahinga yung usok.
Sola says he's grateful their neighborhood has been spared for now, but they are still prepared to evacuate. Officials have warned that the wildfire raging northeast of Amarillo since Monday, dubbed the Smokehouse Creek Fire, is still only 3% contained as of Thursday. The size of the fire, officials say, could cover the city of Los Angeles. Texas Governor Greg Abbott has issued a disaster declaration for 60 counties. In other news, Filipina Patricia Evangelista's book, Some People Need Killing, A Memoir of Murder in My Country, is among the New York Public Library's five finalists for the 37th annual Helen Bernstein Book Award for Excellence in Journalism. The Helen Bernstein Book Award recognizes nonfiction books written by working journalists that shine a spotlight on current events or societal issues that impact readers. Besides the human devastation of the Philippines drug war addressed in Evangelista's book, other important topics covered by the finalists include the environmental impact of the planet's ever-increasing road network, the miracle rise and downfall of dialysis, and America's healthcare system, the extreme ways in which heat is affecting the world, and a tragedy unraveled as a result of America's foster care and adoption systems. The winner of the Bernstein Book Award for Excellence in Journalism will be announced in May. And finally, let's add to The Great White Way, the Tony-winning Broadway musical Hadestown is getting a double dose of major Filipino talent infusion as father and daughter Jonjon and Isa Briones take the stage on March 19. Isa is playing the role of Eurydice while Jonjon takes on Hermes.
I can't wait for everyone to see Isa in this. We've always known she's an amazing actress, an amazing storyteller, and she has an amazing voice.
Isa was in the cast of the first national tour of Hamilton, and her theater credits also include an award-winning performance in a Los Angeles production of Next to Normal. Hadestown is Isa's Broadway debut.
I'm a musical theater kid, and my dad at the time, he was doing Miss Saigon, and that soundtrack, the revival soundtrack, had just come out, and I was listening to it. I think I always dreamed of it. I don't know if I was aware of, is it out of reach, is it not? I just knew that watching my dad on stage, it was that feeling of like, oh, if I'm not on stage, I'm gonna die. Like, I need to do it.
And those are the newsmaking headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa.
Widespread flooding in Bolivia following days of heavy rains. At least 42 have died and 31,000 others displaced. Damage has been heaviest in the northern city of Cobija, which lies across the border from Brazil. The city's mayor has declared the area a disaster zone. In one rural area, local authorities had to dig through mud to allow aid to come through. The administrative capital of La Paz has been put on red alert. At least 43 people are killed after a fire broke out at a seven-story building in the Bangladeshi capital of Dhaka. The fire originated at that popular restaurant, which quickly spread to the upper floors, trapping scores of people. Firefighters used a crane to carry out the rescue. At least 40 others are injured and are being treated in the city's main burn hospital. Authorities have yet to establish the cause of the blaze. carnage at a food aid site in Gaza. At least 112 Palestinians killed and hundreds more were injured after Israeli forces opened fire while they were waiting for food. Palestine's Ministry of Foreign Affairs condemned the incident, calling it a cold-blooded massacre. But Israel's military claims it has no knowledge of shelling at the location. It's also blaming the deaths on Palestinians who are in dire need of aid.
As these vital humanitarian supplies were making their way towards Gazans in need, thousands of Gazans dispensed upon the trucks. Some began violently pushing and even trampling other Gazans to death, looting the humanitarian supplies. The unfortunate incident resulted in dozens of Gazans killed and injured.
Gaza is facing an unprecedented hunger crisis due to the war. The massacre at the food aid site also comes as the Palestinian death toll in the war breaches 30,000. U.S. President Joe Biden says the White House is keeping tabs on the deadly incident in northern Gaza. He believes it would further complicate talks for a truce. Biden earlier said a temporary ceasefire between Israel and Hamas could come by March 4th, but he's not as hopeful now as he was a few days ago.
Hope springs eternal. I was on the telephone with the people in the region. I'm still probably not by Monday, but I'm hopeful.
Do you know what happened in Gaza City? More than 100 civilians were killed.
We're checking that out right now. There's two competing versions of what happened. I don't have an answer yet.
Are you worried about the complications negotiations?
I know, Will.
Are you crazy?
The U.S. State Department also urgently seeking more information on the incident.
Far too many innocent Palestinians have been killed over the course of this conflict. Not just today, but over the past nearly 5 months. If there's anything that the aerial footage of today's incident makes clear, it is just how desperate the situation on the ground is. People need more food. They need more water. They need medicine and other humanitarian goods, and they need it now.
UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres condemning the deadly attack in a Gaza food aid site. Guterres again calls for an immediate ceasefire and the unconditional release of hostages. A UN spokesperson also stresses civilians are dying due to the ongoing conflict and the lack of humanitarian aid.
The desperate civilians in Gaza need urgent help, including those in the besieged northern part of Gaza, where the United Nations has not been able to deliver aid for more than a week. We don't know exactly, I mean, as far as we're concerned, we don't know exactly what happened, but whether people were shot and died as a result of Israeli gunfire, whether they were crushed by a crowd, whether they were run over by trucks, these are all acts of violence, in a sense, due to this conflict.